device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. A current-carrying wire, in the presence of a magnetic field, will always have a tendency to move. This effect is known as motor effect. Want to watch the motor effect? Wind several turns of wire around a cork and suspend it from a clamp. Place this arrangement between the poles of a horseshoe magnet. Switch on the current. The cork moves. Now, reverse the direction of the current. The cork moves in the opposite direction. This experiment shows that the magnetic and electric fields interact to produce a mechanical force. This is the principle of an electric motor. The direction of motion is given by Fleming's left-hand rule. Fleming's left-hand rule. Extend the thumb, forefinger and the middle finger on the left hand in such a way that all the three are mutually perpendicular to each other. If the forefinger points in the direction of the magnetic field, the middle finger in the direction of the current, then the thumb points in the direction of the force exerted on the conductor. A rectangular coil made of insulated copper wire is wound on a soft iron core. This is the armature. The coil is mounted on an axle and placed between the cylindrical concave poles of a magnet. Thus, the armature becomes an electromagnet when a current passes through it. A commutator is used to reverse the direction of flow of current. Commutator is a copper ring split into two parts, C1 and C2. The split rings are insulated from each other and mounted on the axle of the motor. The two ends of the coil are soldered to these rings. They rotate along with the coil. Two small strips of carbon, known as brushes, press slightly against the two split rings, and the split rings rotate between the brushes. The carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. When the coil is powered, a magnetic field is generated around the armature. The left side of the armature is pushed away from the left magnet and drawn towards the right, causing rotation. When the coil turns through 90 degrees, the brushes lose contact with the commutator and the current stops flowing through the coil. However, the coil keeps turning because of its own momentum. Now, when the coil turns through 180 degrees, the sides get interchanged. As a result, the commutator ring C1 is now in contact with the brush B2, and commutator ring C2 is in contact with brush B1. Therefore, the current continues to flow in the same direction. Again, brushes and the split rings lose contact when the coil turns to an angle of 270 degrees. The coil has a tendency to stop, but due to inertia of motion, continues to rotate till it covers 360 degrees. The process continues.
Construction and working of DC motor. Magnetic frame on yoke. This bar acts as a protective cover for the machine and protects the machine from any outside disturbances. It houses a field system and supports the armature through bearings. Stator magnets. They are basically electromagnets with such a arrangement that adjacent poles have opposite polarity. They perform the function of producing the magnetic field. Armature. It is a system of conductors on coil, which is free to rotate on the supported bearing. The armature consists of various parts. We will take each part one by one. To start with, we have armature core. It is made up of high permeability thin silicon content steel laminations. And the outer periphery of the core has slots to carry armature winding. Next is armature winding. It is generally made up of copper wire and is wound over the armature core. Commutator. The commutator is cylindrical in shape and is made up of copper. It performs two basic functions. One being collecting the current from the armature conductor, and the other being converting the alternating current of the armature into the unidirectional current in the external circuit with the help of brushes. They are usually made of carbon or graphite, and the main function of the brush is to collect current from moving commutator. Shaft is a rotating part of the DC motor. We obtain the final output in the form of mechanical energy from the shaft. The armature is mounted over the shaft. We will see the assembly of DC motor. We can now observe in the animation how this motor is practically assembled. After the construction and assembly of DC motor, we will discuss the working in detail. Now, when the battery is connected to DC motor, current starts flowing through the armature. A force is developed in the armature due to the influence of magnetic field of the stator, whose direction is given by Fleming's left hand rule. Now, due to the development of this force in each armature conductor, the armature will rotate in the clockwise direction, and as a result, the shaft will also rotate. Finally, the output power in the form of mechanical energy is obtained from the shaft, which is evident from the movement of fan in the animation.
Working principle of DC motor. Working principle of DC motor is very simple. We can see that when the current conductor is placed in magnetic field, it experiences some force in particularly direction. The very basic construction of a DC motor contains a current carrying armature, which is connected to the supply and through commutator segments and brushes. The armature is placed between north and south pole of a permanent or an electromagnet, an elementary model. One single turn of conductor is placed between two opposite poles. If we start to supply DC via commutator system, current will start to flow. As we see, positive terminal of a battery is connected to left conductor of a turn, and negative terminal is connected to right conductor of a turn. If, as we see in model, north pole of a magnet is placed near left side, and south pole is placed near right side of the turn. Current in left side flows inward, and current in right side flows outward. As we see, conductor is carrying current and they placed in magnetic field. Both of them experienced mechanical force acted on them. Direction of mechanical force can be easily determined by applying Fong direction of the current and left side conductor. Then thumb indicates direction of mechanical force. Similarly, if the forefinger is aligned along direction of magnetic field, from north pole to the south pole, and second finger is aligned along direction of the current in right side conductor, then thumb indicates direction of mechanical force. Due to this upward and downward forces on the turn, one torque is produced when turn rotates on clockwise direction as shown. After rotation of the turn, turn comes to vertical position in respect of the magnetic field. At this position there is no current in conductor because turn, conductor and brushes rest between two commutators. Hence, there is no force acting on conductor, by due to moment of inertia, turn continue to rotate, and comes horizontal again. Position of conductor has been changed here. That means conductor which was previously in left position comes to right position, and which was previously in right position comes to left position. At that position, we can determine mechanical force with applying Fleming's left hand rule. Let's do that. To do this, spread out your left thumb, forefinger, and second finger, so they are all at 90 degrees to one to another. So if forefinger is aligned in direction of magnetic field, that is, from north pole to south pole, and second finger is aligned in direction of a current in the left side conductor, then thumb indicates direction of mechanical force. This is clearly upward here. So if forefinger is aligned in direction of magnetic field, that is, from north pole to south pole, and second finger is aligned in direction of a current in the right side conductor, then thumb indicates direction of mechanical force. This is clearly downward here. Do this upward and downward forces, turn, tends to rotate in clockwise direction. From that explanation we can come to conclusion that, here in this model we can see that, whichever conductor comes near south pole, experience upward mechanical force, and near north pole, downward mechanical force. And do this continuously forces, mechanical turn rotate, even if battery is not connected. Particularly DC motor, rotates, at the same principle like this elementary model. Instead of single turn in DC motor we have mountain turns on major coil. And instead of two poles there is number of poles, installed. I hope that you like it. Please subscribe, like,